Hello everyone, today I'm going to demonstrate one web-based blockchain application built on Ethereum network leveraging AngularJS for the frontend. So before I jump into the code detail, let me quickly explain the overall architecture or layout I put together. Like you can see on the screen, we have Dockerized Angular apps. Actually, we have two different apps. One is the real application, which is a peer-to-peer car sale. It's just a made-up use case. And then we have a blockchain, Ethereum blockchain network. What I'm doing here is, instead of using actual public Ethereum network, I'm using something called test RPC, which is basically a local blockchain network which you can run on your machine or like your Mac or PC, and you don't need a real Ethereum to make the transaction. So that's pretty cool if you want to do something and test something as a developer. So the overall thing goes like that. There is a web application on which a user can post their ads about the car they want to sell, and then the buyer who is looking for cars, they can search for your ad and then purchase the vehicle using a blockchain, and the application will generate one QR code, and the buyer will basically get that QR code, go to the garage like where the car is located, and then in front of the garage there will be one QR code scanner. So the buyer will show the QR code in front of the camera, and camera will scan the QR code, and if you are a legitimate buyer, like who actually did the transaction, then the garage door will open up, and at the same time when the garage door is opened, it will Raspberry Pi will send one notification to the seller that someone opened the garage, and you can see what's going on, and that time seller basically just click on the link which he received from the SNS service, and then see what's going on in his garage in real time. So let's get started. All right, so what you can see here, I have a couple of applications. For example, the Block Explorer. This is the application. This is again Angular application which will help you to see all the blocks being created. P2P card sale smart contracts. I have some smart contracts written in Solidity, which is the language used for Ethereum blockchain. And then I have P2P car sale web, which is basically our application where a seller can put the ad and buyer can purchase that, and it generates the QR code. So all you need to do to set it up on your local, just clone the GitHub repository. I'll be sharing all the details in the readme section. And once you have everything, like once you clone the repository, what you need to do, you just need to execute that Docker compose file. Yeah, definitely you should have Docker installed on your machine. I'll share all the details in the readme. So let's get started. So Docker compose up is basically the command I am issuing, and that will build all the images, and it will start up the services as well. Okay, now you can see, yeah, for me it was pretty quick because all the Docker images were already built on my system, but when you run it for first time it may take a while. Okay, now on the console what you are seeing is basically our Ethereum test network, and by default when you run this application test network, it will create 10 different accounts with private keys and all those things. And also one thing, I'm assuming you know the basics about the blockchain. I'm not going to explain what is blockchain and what are the different parts of it and how we, what are the accounts, private keys, all those things, and wallets. I'm assuming you already know that, and you are a developer, want to develop something on Ethereum network. So that's all from the web application perspective. Everything will be just one line command and you'll get up and running. So now let's go to the browser and see what we got. So for example, localhost 8000, this is where you will see your blockchain network. So currently you can see I don't have any blocks created. And then this is the application, P2P carousel web application. And this is where it'll be selling and buying cards. The UI is not fancy. I just put together for the demonstration purpose. It can be very fancy based on your imagination and skill set. I'm not a very good UI UX person, so that's all I got. And when you click on the drop down, you can see 10 different accounts, and those accounts are basically what you saw when your test RPC started up. Let me pick this one, the first account. So I'm assuming someone logged in and that's the account got selected by default. And then he's putting some ad here, like the Honda model, for example, Civic. Year 2015 and price in Ether. So let's say 20 Ether and create the contract. So once contract is created, system is generating one QR code. I'm not actually going to use that QR code because that's something you can use later on. For example, it will send a notification to you, to someone, or when the browsing page will come. When you click on a certain ad, then it will show up the QR code. You can scan that and go forward with that. But I'm not doing all those complex thing right now. You can do that, but I didn't have enough time, you know, for this part. So what I'll do, I'll basically copy this address, knowing that okay, that's the address for this particular app. And then I'll go to the buy page. This is the page, this is the browsing page actually. So what I am doing here, like I'm basically assuming the second user logged in to buy that, and this is where I'll be pasting that address. Address is basically the address of the block or the contract which is containing the ad for that particular vehicle. Now click on search. So what will happen, it will bring up all the details here, and exact details buyer seller has put together, like Honda Civic 2015, 20 Ether, and the seller address. And now go back to our blockchain explorer and see what's going on there. So now you can see another block just created, which is basically the contract. And you can look at the details and everything, like has, from where it came from, and the gas used for this one. So all those details you will find it here. And now assume that buyer wants to buy this. He is happy with the offer and he clicks on buy. So you can see as soon as the purchase is complete, the balance of the user went down 20 Ether, and it'll be wondering like why it's 79.99. It should have been $80 because 100 minus 20 is 80, but actually buyer had to spend some Ether for the transaction processing, so that's the fee miner gets. And we're not running real miners here because it's all run on test network. So mining is done automatically, but in real time, in the real Ethereum network, the transaction may take little while until your block is mined by miners and put it in the blockchain. So now when you go to the blockchain explorer, probably let's see what's going on there now. Yep, so as expected, you can see another block which is the sale contract. So seller buyer bought that, and miner mined that block and put it in the blockchain. So you can see now the second block has been created, and if you go inside, you can see all the details about that. Okay, so now so that's the web application part, so that's pretty cool. That's done, and then what I'm going to do, I'm going to take a picture of this QR code, because that's what the buyer receives, and then he will walk to the garage, like assuming the garage address will be there in the contract. I did not put that, but yeah, just assume that's there, and buyer got the details, and then he is going to walk to the garage. So what I'm doing right now, I'm basically taking a picture of that. Basically what I have it here, that's the garage door, and then I have it here, the web camera, which is our QR code scanner, and then I have a little speaker over here, which is powered by Amazon Polly. It's kind of text to voice transformation, so it will speak to you. And then there is a Raspberry Pi which is connected to one server over here, and then there is another camera module. This is a Raspberry Pi camera, and that will be responsible for live streaming. So what will happen when the buyer comes and scan the QR code, then it will read the QR code, and if you are a legitimate buyer, then it will send a signal to AWS IoT, and it will update the shadow, and it will signal that the garage door should open now, and then it will send the signal, and Raspberry Pi will receive that and process it and send the signal to servo motor here, and servo motor will open up the garage. And at the same time, it will send a push notification to the seller, giving a link where seller can see what's going on using this camera. So let's get started. So what I did, I basically scanned the QR code. If you really want to see that, what I got here is, so I basically took a picture of that, and I'm going to scan it. Okay, before that, what I need to do, I'm going to log into my Raspberry Pi and start the program. This is how you're going to start up your program. So rpc underscore url, and you're giving the url, and I'm just starting the node application here. Okay, so our program is program has started, and it's waiting for the QR code to be scanned. So Isn't it cool? So it verified your credential and all those things, and then it opened up the garage, and at the same time it has sent me one notification. If you can see here, not so good, but you can see some, I got some text message here. If I click on that, you can see something. I don't know whether you can read it properly. It's an issue with the focus, but there is a link actually. So if you open up that link, and you can see it's a live stream, what's going on. For example, if you see, like, I'm moving the car here, and you can see my fingers. I'm trying to show it better, but I'm unable. But you got the concept. Like, you can see it's a live stream, it's moving, and it's all coming from this little camera. So if I move the camera, then you can see, like, things are changing. So it's basically live stream you're getting. So let me put it up. So yep, so that's all about it. And then in future I'll be putting some more code in it, so that once a buyer moves out and takes the car away, then seller can see. So this is what I was talking about. So what I did, I basically pushed a button on the phone, and then I signaled, okay, the garage door should be closed now, and it will close the garage door. So that's all about this particular demo, or the little use case I put together. All right guys, thanks for watching the video. Bye.